Hey guys, hope you're all doing well. Now for today's video, we're going to be going over the brand new trailer that just came out for season 2 of the new Netflix series Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous. There is a lot of stuff to talk about in this new footage, and I think it's best if we just go ahead and jump straight into it. So yeah, that didn't take long at all. Immediately after season 1 ends and we got the news that Dominion got pushed back a year, we got season 2 of Camp Cretaceous. Now, the first season was really, really well received, and I think it exceeded a lot of people's expectations. So when the teaser for season 2 dropped, a lot of people just kind of got really stoked to see more of the show that they've grown to love. So the first thing that we see when the trailer starts is Isla Nublar. We see that all of the dinosaurs have kind of been let out of their cages, they're running around and foraging through all kinds of different material, and the Compies have even taken over an abandoned gyrosphere, which actually looks to be the same gyrosphere, by the way, that the Sinoceratops ran into during season 1, because it's got that hole right there where the horn was supposed to be. Then we get the introduction of a big Tyrannosaur foot, and of course, just like season 1, the trailer goes off in a much more dark direction. One of the things that I really like about this teaser trailer is the fact that it really is going for a more darker, very Fallen Kingdom-esque or The Lost World sort of tone. And they nail it right out of the park. You see Darius right here getting scared of the Tyrannosaur shadow that's walking behind him. It's just really, really cool stuff. The T-Rex was not in season 1 of Camp Cretaceous. Why? Well, because in canon, it was locked up until Claire lit the flare and let it out to fight the Indominus at the end of Jurassic World. So now with the Tyrannosaur Rex fully out and running around the island, things are probably going to get really, really bad for these kids as they try to survive. Possibly my favorite part of the trailer is with Sammy, Brooklyn, and Yaz all cowering behind this room of some sorts while a Baryonyx raises its head up and starts to walk right by them. Now, we knew for a long time that the Baryonyx was going to play a big part in the show, and this was mainly from the Mattel toys that were coming out for it. A lot of people expected a lot more dinosaurs in season 1, me included. I had all these crazy ideas of Cryolophosaurus, and I think Dinosuchus was one of the toys they released. None of that stuff came out in the first season, but we are finally getting the berries that we knew were going to be in the show from the start. Now, the reason that I think it's taken this long for us to actually see footage of them is because what Netflix and DreamWorks will usually do, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they start out their series by making 16 episodes. And then what they do is cut those 16 episodes in half and do a season 1, which is just the first 8, and then they'll drop season 2, which is really just the final 8 of the full 16 episode package. So yeah, Baryonyx was getting teased early on because it was always a part of the show. We just hadn't seen anything of it yet. Now, I just love this image right here. The Baryonyx looking dark with this sort of blue color palette. It reminds me so much of the Indoraptor from Fallen Kingdom, which the imagery in that movie I just thought was awesome. I love the horror, sort of dark and bleak look of people cowering from dinosaurs, and the Baryonyx itself right here just looks very menacing. I know a lot of people aren't too keen on the design of the Baryonyx, and myself included, it's not one of my favorites, but right here, it's just looking really, really menacing, and I think it's going to make for a really cool scene wherever this plays out. And then, of course, we've got this really important image right here that I don't think a lot of people are really looking into. We've got Yaz, Sammy, Darius, Kenji, and Brooklyn. Noticeably, Ben is not there. Now, if you watched all of season 1 all the way through the credits, I believe it's at the end of the credits, you'll see that Bumpy actually ran into Ben, and he was kind of twitching his hand, so he's probably not dead. However, at this point in the show, they're not regrouping with Ben or Bumpy just yet, so maybe these kids are going to be under the opinion or thought that, like, I guess Ben died, and they have to fight and fend for themselves alone while, you know, they've got this terror in the back of their head, like, hey, we could die at any moment here. Ben got killed. I don't know what Kenji has as a weapon. It looks like a butter knife or a scalpel or something. Sammy has a stick. Yaz has a stick. Darius has like a 2x4 or a stake. And somehow Brooklyn got a baseball bat. I'm not sure any of that's going to be very good weaponry to fight dinosaurs, especially the dinosaur that they're about to run into, which is this giant Ceratosaurus, which we finally see again, which really hasn't been seen since Jurassic Park 3. Now, if you look at the Ceratosaurus in this actual image here, I'm not so sure this is an exact identical replication of the animal that we saw in Jurassic Park 3, but what I think this does really tell us is it's just more confirmation that they were taking dinosaurs from Site B and putting them in Jurassic World. I know I talk about that a lot, but there's so much evidence on screen for that happening. The Ceratosaurus doesn't look anywhere near radically redesigned, so it's not a brand new clone like, say, the Jurassic World Pteranodons or the Jurassic World Ankylosaurs or anything like that, or the Stegosaurs, really. This looks a lot like the JP3 Ceratosaur, so I would not be surprised if they talk about in the show, or if we can just tell by it running around and looking like this, that yeah, it's just more confirmation that they're taking animals from Isla Sorna and dropping them in Jurassic World. I have no idea how these guys are going to survive this dinosaur, but they better run fast, because for the first time in series history, Ceratosaurus is coming back and actually trying to kill somebody. It just kind of smelled the poopy and walked away in JP3, but now it's being a carnivore for real. And then, of course, we've got this great money shot of the Tyrannosaurus Rex roaring on Main Street. We didn't really get to see much of Main Street at all in Season 1. In fact, if you actually go back and look at the Mosasaurus Lagoon scene in Season 1, they do kind of a quick whip pan where they go through where you're supposed to see Main Street, which is like right next to the lagoon, and it's just all trees. So I'm not so sure if they've made it, why they couldn't include it next to the lagoon, unless there's some sort of weird budgetary constraint around the rendering of all these locations or something else that I don't know about. But if you ever want a really good Easter egg for Season 1, Main Street is like completely gone when they flash right across the screen and show you a whole bunch of jungle. And the very last shot that we get of the show is actually of somebody's hand being put into a footprint. Now, I think a lot of people are going to expect this to be Bumpy or, you know, at least some sort of other dinosaur that the kids might come to know. I'm really under the impression that it is Bumpy, and it looks like, if it is, I could be wrong here, but that footprint is probably way bigger than what Bumpy was the last time we saw her. So we know that Dr. Wu talked about the accelerated growth rate, which was given to all the dinosaurs. Bumpy grew like 50 times her original mass within the span of like a day. So I'm guessing when we do meet up with Ben and Bumpy, which I'm sure we will sometime in Season 2, the dinosaur is going to be much, much bigger. Now, that being said, I think this trailer shows us a lot of stuff for the next iteration of Camp Cretaceous to get excited for, and in my opinion, this is one of the best trailers for anything Jurassic I've ever really seen. You know, there's other stuff like the Super Bowl trailer for the Lost World Jurassic Park, or really the standard trailer for the Lost World. Those are really, really good. And then, of course, you've got, you know, the Jurassic World teaser, and the Fallen Kingdom second trailer I thought was great. But this right here is, it's just one of the best Jurassic Park trailers I've ever seen. It shows dinosaurs, it shows kids in peril, it shows this big landscape of everything's just ruined and terrible, and these kids have to fight for survival. It actually really gives me off a feel of Jurassic Park 3, but in a way that I don't think a lot of people have thought about. For example, Jurassic Park 3, one of the things a lot of people questioned in that movie was how Eric Kirby survived on the island for 8 weeks as a 12-year-old alone. And I know that they show him eating Crunch bars and collecting T-Rex pee and living in the water truck with his Jumanji outfit and stuff, but a lot of people, they wanted to see the terror and the sort of scared nature of a child lost on this island full of dinosaurs, and we didn't really see that happen. We saw the aftermath of him sort of just surviving. Now, it looks like they've taken the premise of kids alone on a dinosaur island, and we get to see them actually fight for survival. So this is going to be really cool in my opinion. I'm really looking forward to seeing where they take this show, and if it lines up with something like the beginning of Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, where the mercenaries go back to the island, retrieve the Indominus Rex rib bone. I'm sure they could do that in order to have some more Mosasaurus action, because if these kids are even remotely intelligent, they're not going anywhere near the lagoon, because that's just signing their own death warrant. They've already evaded that thing once. They shouldn't go anywhere near there again. Now, I know that there's a lot of speculation that the kids might wander into the ruins of the 1993 Jurassic Park that nobody really saw in season one, and we saw little bits and pieces of in the first Jurassic World. And actually, we saw a few locations in Fallen Kingdom too, but I think what a lot of people would really, really enjoy is just having those kids wander about to, I don't know, the old Rex paddock, or maybe the old visitor center again, or something of that magnitude. The T-Rex is out now. It's going to be wandering around wherever it can. The whole island is its domain now. Nothing is going to challenge it, or at least nothing that we know of. Season 1 did have a little tease where Dr. Wu had the Spinosaurus skeleton on his desktop computer, so who knows, maybe Spinosaurus could be making an appearance as well. Ceratosaurus is in this, and that's a JP3 animal. The only reason I would think that Spinosaurus wouldn't be in this show would be that they might be trying to save that animal for Dominion. I know for a fact they really want, they've thought about putting the Spinosaurus back in a movie for a while. Originally it was gonna be in Fallen Kingdom, I've talked about that a lot, but it wasn't in that movie at the end of the day. Now, is it gonna be in Camp Cretaceous Season 2? We have no evidence. It could be, but right now we just have what is on screen. One dinosaur in particular that we didn't see anything of, and I thought it was pretty interesting though, where was Toro? Now, Toro got banged up pretty bad at the end of season one, so if he survived, I'm sure that we're going to be seeing him somewhere along the line. Maybe while he's wounded, he'll fight the T-Rex, or, well, I don't think that'd be much of a fight, but maybe he'll fight some of these Baryonyx or something, who knows. I think, though, right now, as it stands, season two, Camp Cretaceous, this is very exciting. I hope that this is just as good as season one, if not better, and with all that being said, I'd love to hear what all of you think. What are your thoughts and opinions on the Season 2 teaser trailer for Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous? It looks like Ben's nowhere to be found. We didn't see any of Bumpy, but we did get a pretty big footprint. What do you think they're going to do with the T-Rex? What do you think they're going to do with the Baryonyx? Do you think they'll go in a darker tone like what Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom did? I love that more horror-ish, like, just dark nature of Jurassic. I really am looking forward to this, and I want to hear what all of you guys have to say about it in the comments down below. Now before I go, I'd like to thank all of my game wardens, as well as all of my engine executives. I'd also like to thank all of my park workers and engine hunters as well. Kobe Roaming and Engine Hunter 90. Guys, it seriously means the world to me that you all have continued to support what I do, and I never want you to ever forget that. Now I'd like to thank you all for watching today's video, and hope that you all enjoyed the content. If you feel like I deserve it, I'd appreciate the like and hope that you'll consider subscribing if you're interested in hearing from me again. I'll see you on the next video, guys, and as always, take it easy.